Rhonda. Welcome to One More Avenue. We're standing outside of Los Alamitos Television, Channel 3, just about ready to do a show, so I hope you'll come
and join. Excuse me. We're ready for On the Set. We can roll tape anytime you want.
Oh, good.
And you're sure you want to do that song?
I really want to do that song.
It's corny. We'll do it.
Come okay, great. Thanks. Come on in.
I'll just go in and start tape rolling. And let's go ahead and go on in. And I'll start pushing buttons here.
Okay.
And magic video, it'll happen.
Okay, great. I'm so excited. I can't wait.
Rhonda? Rhonda? Hey.
What?
You want to do the show? We're ready.
Oh, okay.
Unless you want to do another song or something.
Okay. Well, I'd like to do another song, but hey, here, we'll talk.
Good. I hope take off my glasses here. I don't like these things.
Okay, oh, I don't like wearing glasses either. I wear them, but I never use them because I'm a little vain.
On stage, you got to look your best, and people...
Oh, yes, very important. I'm sitting here with a newfound friend of mine, Dan Smith, station manager for LA TV. I had the pleasure of becoming acquainted with him about a year ago. I saw an ad on TV that said, anyone who's interested in producing a show, come on over. And so I did. And I met this lovely gentleman, and we've become friends. He's given me the opportunity to produce a couple of other shows, and now the opportunity to produce my own. And so I'd like you to learn a little bit about this man. What I find about him most is that he's diligent, hardworking, very versatile, and he's good to everybody that comes in. He's a wonderful person. And since a lot of you watch LATV, I'd like you to see what goes on behind the scenes. So please meet Dan Smith.
Hi.
Dan.
Thanks. Thanks for having me on.
We didn't know each other. Can you tell us a little bit about your background first, how you came into this kind of work and how you ended up here?
Actually, I guess around fifth grade was the first time there was a group film project, 8mm film, and we actually had the instructor put it together. We didn't have any hands-on, but it was just kind of almost, let's shoot a bunch of kids playing in front of the camera and we'll have the teacher splice it together.
This was in school?
Yeah.
That you had this opportunity? That's cool.
And I kind of started to get the acting bug. And in seventh grade, I ended up in a school, which is very unusual. Mm-hmm. With electives and everything, you could actually have arts for 8 out of 10 periods.
That's
so
fabulous.
In the core class, we were doing a radio drama, dance, music. We even had Hitchcockian editing.
Oh my goodness.
In a junior high. Seventh graders were learning things that normally don't touch till college. But I wanted to be an actor,
yeah.
You know, have all the attention, be the romantic lead. Didn't happen, of course.
Aww.
What happened was that we, I don't know if you've taken acting classes or
yes.
not, you have to do 5-minute scenes,
mm-hmm.
and, but we had 3 people normally in a group.
Yeah.
So I was like, well, we're all trying to, because we're all vain, we're all actors, we wanted to find something that had equal number of lines
for
each
so
person.
Important.
We couldn't. So 2 of us in the group started writing our own scenes.
You were one of those.
Right. And one of the other fellows dropped out, but there were 3 of us that stayed together through high school writing stuff for not only our own performing, but for other high school and community theaters in the area.
Right.
So we'd have stuff performed at about 4 different stages.
Wow.
So I was acting, but at the same time I was writing.
And this was junior high?
Yeah, I started at age 12.
My goodness.
And so by 17, I've been able to actually win an award for something that I wrote and directed in
That's
a one-act
fabulous.
Competition, which kind of pissed off some of the other older people there. They're wondering what the heck I was.
Oh, sure. With all of that background behind you so early on. That's
yeah,
great.
I did, I think it was 34 plays and musicals by the time I was 17 in 4 different stages.
And a lot of that you were acting in?
Yes, I was singing, acting, dancing.
Dancing, did you say?
Yes.
Oh, great.
It's kind of funny. When I got into college, I was one of those people who kept changing majors almost immediately.
Oh.
And at one point, I was in the drama department at Cal State Fullerton, and someone walked in the door and said, we have the Oakland Ballet coming through town. And they need extras.
So you got out your tights?
I never had done ballet before. But it ended up being my last performance on stage as a performer was dancing Scheherazade with the Oakland Ballet, which just looks great on a
That's
resume.
Fabulous.
But I actually got to go out there and there were 5 guards and we basically killed the princess.
Oh.
And that was the last curtain call I had.
Oh.
And that was 1980. So
oh
it's been 17
gosh.
Years I've been on the other side of a camera, stage, what have you.
Mm-hmm. What made you make that transition? It wasn't really a transition, I guess, because you were kind of doing it all along, but how did you let go of the acting and the performing part?
It was a watershed moment. I was watching Three's Company, which I don't like those kind of shows, but I was just, it was on,
Killing
and Don
Time.
Knotts came on,
yeah.
And I thought, and he just had some terribly unfunny things to do.
Mm.
I thought, here's this fellow, he's at the top of his profession, of the acting profession that I want to get into.
Mm-hmm.
And all he can do is say lines that someone else has written. He has to ask someone else for a job. And here's this, one of the most talented comedians working at that time.
No control.
Thought,
he just had to do what he was told, like a puppet.
Yeah, I thought, this is the apex. This is as good as you get.
That's sad.
And I thought, no, I want to be the guy who writes the lines or who puts everything together.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when I made the decision to try to be somewhere on the other side of things. Also, about that same time, I had the Writers Guild, and the Screen Actors Guild figures, which said that the unemployment rate for a actor was 99%, oh. Whereas behind the scenes it was only 94%.
There's the motivation.
So, yeah. I was about six times more likely to get a job,
yes.
I figured, behind the scenes than in front of it.
Well, also, too, if you're in control, you can always put yourself back in if you ever want to. I mean, if you're producing a show, why not act in it, too?
I was reading the other day, there's a fellow named Steve Odekirk, mm-hmm. here from Orange County. Started as a performer, didn't make it as a performer, made it as a writer and director of Jim Carrey's mm-hmm. films. And now he has the power to go back and do his own thing and be
That's
in front
fabulous.
Of a camera.
Mm-hmm. So it was about control of the whole creative project and not just acting in it.
Right.
And that transition was made when you were about 17?
Consciously when I was 17, but I've been writing and having mm-hmm. stuff, you know, performed elsewhere for about mm-hmm. 5 years.
So then where did you go to school after you got out of high school?
Went to Fullerton College, mm-hmm. which, just because I concentrated so much on performing and all this, that I hadn't worried about things like grade point averages or scholarships or anything like that. So
that was the only school you could get into at the time?
Right.
Okay.
We called UCLC, University, corner of Lemon and Chapman.
Oh.
And I changed majors from undeclared to journalism to drama to, I think, something else within that 1 year.
My goodness. And they actually have a good creative program in a lot of those areas.
Now they do. At the time, I didn't go into video. Video was actually really strong at that point. I only did productions with Fullerton College after I moved to Cal State Fullerton. And they were actually bringing people for their big productions to the Fullerton College department, where they had a full-on 26-foot broadcast truck and everything.
Yes.
But I was film at that point. I wasn't, video was just, you know, this industrial sort of thing.
So that was not your area at that time then? It was strictly film?
Yeah, I was just going to be directing the next big film. And
it was
that's
like
where
a Steven Spielberg thing where it was only going to be movies and that was it.
I was going to write and direct. I might stoop to having my own series on television, but only if I could produce it.
Yes, okay.
So, yes, age 18, there's a lot of dreams which don't necessarily match up with the real world.
True.
But I was trying, mm-hmm. and I was working even at that point.
And you did have a lot of background and experience, so that you knew there was a lot that you could do. You just needed the opportunity.
One thing about the industry is that people always say, well, gee, there's, you know, if you're submitting a script, there's 50,000 other scripts.
Mm-hmm.
But the quality and the naivety of the people submitting those scripts is so low, mm-hmm. it's easy to get at least a shot.
That's true. And you figured that you at least had some kind of quality going, given your ideas and given your background as well.
Yeah, given some mm-hmm. training and just putting things together in a way that doesn't show that you're a legend in your own mind,
mm-hmm. yes.
people will look at it, they will actually read it.
Mm-hmm. And you can kind of think of yourself as a legend in your own mind at 18.
Or that no one is as good as you, but
yes.
the art has to be there. I remember reading my favorite author, Roger Zelazny, mm-hmm. said that a work has to stand on its own. There should be no explanation needed to understand that work. You shouldn't have to tell someone, oh, this is what I'm trying to do with this.
So given time, this will be of total quality, because I'm young.
Or that, well, you've got to understand what we're going to have here is this.
Yes.
You know, I try to leave that out. If I write a script, it's all there.
Just be able to hand it to someone. Okay, so you went from Fullerton College to Fullerton State, and you graduated with what degree finally?
Bachelor of Arts.
Okay, that encompasses
4 years.
Everything.
And
then on to where from there? What was your emphasis? Even though you had a Bachelor of Arts.
Ended up in communications with an emphasis in radio, TV, film.
Okay.
I made the mistake of picking up the wrong requirement sheet.
Uh-oh.
For the emphasis. It was an old one, when they didn't have a lot of video equipment, where you actually had to learn still photography, including the developing and the printing,
mm-hmm.
and 16mm filmmaking, as well as video.
Wow. So it covered a lot of things.
And I was going, taking classes based upon that sheet. I found out that was the wrong one.
Uh-oh.
But I was taking far more than I needed to take.
Well, see, it was meant to be, because you probably used a lot of that since then.
What I found was that I could do any one of several areas. So I could walk in and be what I called a triple threat.
Mm.
I could do stage work,